Interac has virtually pioneered the way in terms of, you know, real-time money transactions. But when you look forward, when you look at that horizon in this digital economy, what do you do next? How do you stay ahead of that curve? How do you innovate in this kind of environment?
Well, I think a couple of things. So you're right. Basically, I think Interac is if not the first, but the original homegrown fintech here in Canada. And one of the things we pretty well invented was this email money transfer, which is a totally different type of payment. It's a push payment from account to account, and Canadians, I think we're going to hit 500 million transactions this year, which, put in context, is larger than many people know Venmo in the United States. It's, I believe, still larger than Venmo, even though we're 1/10 the size of their country, which is incredible. But the future really is about something we just launched, which is request money and auto deposit. So e-transfer has been an amazing service for Canadians to get money to, whether it's your kid in university or splitting a bill or paying your debts. Now, instead of remembering to send money, you can actually request money. So my son can say, hey, Dad, I'm going out, click here, and the money's instantly in his account. Think about that now if you're a small business, if you're a landscaper, if you're a housekeeper. This now becomes a little invoicing tool where you can say, hey, Mark, for the last 3 lawn cuttings, click here, you owe me $60. Bang, the money goes directly into the merchant's account. So us launching request money is also ahead of the world. The United States still doesn't have that technology, for example. And then when you go further, this type of payment, we're all right now on checks, cash, and cards. And they do a very great, you know, they do a great job. Canadians are the highest per capita debit users in the world because of Interac's ubiquity. However, the days, I believe in Card-mageddon is what it's called. So like everyone's been saying, the check and cash will go away. I think cards will have, they're going to have a fairly long tail, but they're also going to go away. And payments in the future, even when you're at the point of sale, buying your coffee or what have you, are going to be an e-transfer-like payment, a push payment directly from your account into the Starbucks or Tim Hortons account immediately, without the need for, if you think about terminals and all of that, it's almost like doing an e-commerce transaction, but you're face-to-face.
Where does Interac fit in with this, within this payment ecosystem of Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies?
So that's an interesting one, and as you know, they've had their challenges. But what I like to focus on is the technology below those. So currencies aside, it's something called blockchain, which is a distributed ledger technology. That is exciting to me because payments are very database, and we all have our old database technology that's been around forever. You think about Oracle databases. This blockchain is an ability to have a super database, very fast, anonymous, secure database at the base of payments. So we're doing a number of proof of concepts with blockchain right now to see how could Interac take the foundation it's built as a central information exchange and layer in blockchain to even improve safety, security, and speed for Canadians?
You mentioned Card-mageddon, and I want to ask you, because the way people are spending money and how they're spending it is a different concept these days. Are you seeing a difference in transactions with all these grocery apps and, I guess, more mobile apps that make shopping much more readily available to people? Are you seeing a difference in transactions?
Absolutely. If I think back, Interac started as an ATM network. If you think back to the mid-80s, that's when the ATM was the newest technology known to anyone. And Interac was originally a network of all bank accounts in the country accessing ATM. Now we moved into the card, now we've moved into e-commerce and e-transfer. And the fastest growing element of payments by far is people either doing an e-commerce transaction, picking up in store, sometimes letting you do an e-commerce transaction within the store and walk out with your goods, or as we all know, ordering off of the Amazons and the like. And so our partnerships with, you know, Samsung, Google, Apple were embedded into the Apple Pay and Google Pay, so in-app. That's a huge bastion for us. And then embedding e-transfer as a way to pay online safely and securely is also the next I think, evolution of payments.